call that the greatest love story ever told. That's by my niece, Angel Chisholm. That's my girl. I'm just so happy that we tuned in again. Once again, I'm sitting here on the couch with another mother. It happens to be my sister, Jackie Clark Chisholm. Welcome to the Dorinda Show, hon. How are you doing? This is my oldest sister.
Yes,
she looks so cute. You know, I told her, I was looking at her lashes. I said,
George, you got her lashes looking better than mine.
That's right, George. I'm the oldest.
She came in here at the last minute and got her face looking better than mine. Oh,
praise God.
Thank God for George.
My oldest sister. She looks beautiful, don't you?
And look at her hair.
That's it. That's good.
How old are you now?
2010. I'm not telling you.
I'm over 50. Over something else, too.
50,
over something else, too.
When you're over.
Over something
over
else.
Over the hill.
I'm over the hill.
Happy Mother's Day to all the mothers out there.
Happy Mother's Day.
Hey, I'm just so glad, Jackie. We are sitting here, and we are talking to all the moms and just giving them some really great love today because they have really worked so hard, you know, bringing up children,
yes.
And it's really kind of, sometimes it's difficult when you've got children that are leaving adolescence, going into their teenage, you know, years, and then some that are going from teenagers to, I'm grown now,
right.
And I'm on my own. So, as we see Angel's sitting here, so we got the typical example.
Yeah, she's
only grown.
Tell
us about you being a mom and, you know, the repercussions it is for children to leave from one stage to the other.
I think that it's real important that your children have a really good base. If they have a good base and a good foundation, going to church and making sure that you teach them to fear the Lord, just like Mama taught us. And I guess if you look at our children, and we often talk about this, how we look at where we came from, and we see what God allowed Mama to pour into us, we pour into our children. And the good thing about it is when you have good kids who don't give you any trouble, who don't get involved with the wrong people. And I think that came from, you know, us not letting our children go any and everywhere, not staying with any and everybody, and making sure that when you allow them to go places, if you allow them to go places where you know that they're going to be in a wholesome background or a wholesome situation. And so a lot of times kids are, you know, mistreated and dealt with unfairly because their parents don't investigate where their children are going. So one of the things that Mama did with us was she would never let us go to anybody's house. So that was just kind of like where we was raised. And that's kind of the same thing we did with her. With Angel, with Jay, with Kiki, Auntie Nika Wilson, who took care of our kids when we were traveling, and nobody else, we wouldn't let anybody else keep those kids. And to this day, they love her like she's still their grandmother. So I think, and because she was a God-fearing woman and she put the same thing in them, so everybody that was involved in their life was an extension of who we are.
Yeah.
And so being an extension of who we are is why you see what you see in our children today.
Yeah.
I'm very proud of Angel, and I know sometimes she thinks that I'm difficult, but that most teenagers do, most young adults do. You know, she don't want me to say teenager, but she's not a teenager, but she is a young adult.
Yeah.
How old are you? 21? 22? How old are you gonna be?
How old are you?
22. Oh, she's 22.
Thank you. Yeah. And we gotta tell them, Jackie. We gotta tell us. TCT viewers about the ages of our children now because all of us, me, Jackie, and Karen, we were all pregnant around the same time. We were all mothers.
30 days apart.
At the same time.
Right.
You know, 30 days apart, and we happened to be on the road during that time.
That's right.
You know, singing on the
right.
And, of course, it was so funny how it happened because Karen started getting sick when we was on the road. She kept saying, "Oh, I just feel so bad. I don't know what's going on." And so she said, "I'm going to go to the doctor." So she went to the doctor, and the doctor told her she was pregnant. So she was pregnant with Kiki. All right. Then the next month, we were still on the road traveling. The next month, I started saying, "Oh, I don't feel right. Maybe I got a cold. I don't know what's wrong. I got to find out what's in Jackie." She said, "Yeah, you better go to the doctor." So I went to the doctor, and I had a cold, all right. I had a J-cold. And then the next month, Jackie
I got sick.
Ow!
three.
Yeah.
Then Jay, because Kier's born in June.
June.
Jay was born in July, and Angel was born in August.
Yeah.
And so they're very close,
yeah.
And it's because they were born together, so they were always kept together.
Right.
And I'm just grateful that God put in them what they did. Kier is such a phenomenal singer, and I'm so proud of her. And J. Cole, who started to do his little music, his thing with music, I'm really proud of him.
Yeah.
And then I came back
Angel.
And I watched Angel.
Yeah.
Angel is beginning to do a lot of writing. So we're really excited about what the kids are doing. I love to see the fact that they are staying within the church and within the boundaries of the church. You know, it doesn't matter to me, you know, when she's writing stuff, as long as she's writing things that are going to be positive into people's lives. And as long as she writes things that are going to make things happy for other people and not things that are degrading to people,
mm-hmm.
Those are the things that I really want to see her do. But I want to also make sure that she does things that are going to glorify and magnify the Word of God, because that's the way we've taught them.
Right. Angel, I want you to talk to us about your writing ability, because her writing ability is just top-notch. I've never seen nobody write like her, and we always talk about Angel and her writing. She wrote a song off of Yanti Karen's new CD. Tell us about your writing,
though. I actually started writing. I did my first one was actually on the James Fortune album.
James Fortune.
I did one song on there, and then we started working on Karen's album, and she heard one of the songs that I wrote with J. Drew, and she liked it so much, and it was just like, you know, when I heard her do it, I was like, wow, okay, so, you know, we were working on that, and it was funny, because she was going to feature me and Kiera on the song, and I went in to do my part,
right,
and she was working on another song,
okay,
and she was like, well, you here. You can write songs all fast and stuff. Let me see how you do do this one, because I can't think.
Yeah.
So I was like, okay. So I wrote a verse and the vamp on another song of hers called Hold On.
Right.
And then they got done with that, and Kiki hadn't got there yet, so she went to another song and had me do another verse on that one. So I actually ended up going from one to three on
That's wonderful.
But
what was the name of the song?
The first one, the one that I initially wrote, is called Lord Take Me.
Okay.
It was a song that I wrote. It was about a last form of repentance. Like you ever feel like you have reached the end of your grace, like your limits have, you've reached your limit, and in this song, I was just begging God to take me back.
Yeah.
You know, and a lot of times we don't know we don't know when our grace runs out.
Yeah.
But, you know, I keep messing up, I keep doing the same thing over and over again. But I don't like this, God. I don't like being here. So can you please just take me back? I don't care what I got to do, what I got to say, how I have to act. Just please. I can't even cry no more. I just want to come back.
Yeah.
So that was the first one. Then the next one is called Hold On.
Yeah.
And that was a song that Karen wrote, and I just helped her. And then the last one's called Crazy Praise.
Yes, that's what I love. That's what I love.
Crazy Praise.
But very talented writer and musician, and she's just doing some awesome things. I'm so proud of Angel. And even my nephew, J. Drew, and Kiera and Jay, all of them are doing so good. So, and Jackie, we think about this a lot of times, even when we're moms, you know, we look at our children, and you said something that was very profound, that if we put them in the right environment, they have no other way to do right but to stay right.
Stay right, that's
right. And that's one of the things that we really, really try to give initiative to a lot of the mothers out there.
Right.
So I want to say this to all the mothers that are listening, that may God continue to bless you as your day, as you celebrate this Mother's Day. And